Commission and the European Union has a combined approach. It is partly economic and partly cultural. And their task with the collaboration of the member states in relation to producing the Audiovisual Media Services Directive was to bring together both the cultural and the economic. Then the EU is also putting together or revising what is called the Telecom Package, which is a collection of four directives and which is not only economic but also highly political. It's essentially about the telecoms and transmission infrastructure. So there is some relationship in the overall approach of the European Union between the Audiovisual Media Services Directive, which updates the 1989 Television Without Frontiers Directive, and the EU Telecom Package, which is to do with transmission and transmission infrastructure. So that is technical and transmission, and that is content. And they're all part of a large picture to achieve an appropriate degree of EU harmonisation, not only for economic and growth reasons, but also for free flow and internal market reasons. The thinking behind the Television Without Frontiers Directive, which preceded the Audiovisual Media Services Directive, was that you have a basic set of rules which all broadcasters throughout the European Union conform to. Once those rules are complied with at the member state level, the signals of the broadcasters should be free to cross borders. Because plainly, even in 1989, and particularly now, and with the internet, it is obvious, you have to have one basic set of rules. You cannot, in producing content, take into account multiple jurisdictions. So the logic in the 80s and the 90s of the first directive and now the Audiovisual Media Services Directive is to create a degree of legal certainty, a minimal amount of regulation, and to enable signals to cross borders without jeopardy. And then on the right, the Council of Europe, André referred to this. It is a very important part of the audiovisual regulatory landscape. I use the phrase regulatory in a very loose sense, because the measures of the Council of Europe are recommendations. They do not have the same force as directives. However, it is a very, very important forum for public service broadcasting because it takes predominantly a cultural approach. And so those, I think, are the three key measures that one needs to take into account in looking at the legislative landscape as one goes forward. Looking in a bit more detail at the European Union and their initiatives, as I say, I picked the Audiovisual Media Services Directive as one of a number of measures. I referred to the Telecom Package. It was originally introduced in 2002. It's due for revision on the 13th of November. We believe the Commission will be publishing its new proposals in relation to updating the Telecom Package. There are good things and bad things as far as public service broadcasting is concerned, as far as we understand, contained in the Telecom Package. But the main concern at the moment is about spectrum allocation. Then there is, as I say, the Audiovisual Media Services Directive. Copyright, I'm not going to touch on today, but it is absolutely vital. Without a sensible regime in relation to copyright, there can be no wide dissemination of content. And without content, however many marvelous new platforms one has, it is all pretty pointless unless you can actually clear the programs to have them on them. We've already heard that certain broadcasters have archive channels. Archive and clearance of the rights in archive material is one of the major challenges in the next few years. And finally, state aid. André referred in some detail to the state aid decisions. This is about the funding of public service broadcasting. And in that context, the Amsterdam Protocol, which was a protocol to the treaty, the EU treaty in 1997, which reinforces the importance of member state authority in relation to determination of the remit and, in particular, the financing of public service broadcasting, so that it can carry out its function, it being public service broadcasting, in underpinning and contributing to the cultural, social, and democratic life of the member states.